Hey everybody, what is up? This is Devin LaVore coming at you. It's been a minute, right? Man, it's because God's just been doing so many amazingly cool things. So many cool things. So many heart things. So many heart preparation things. You know, so many things, you know? Me and my family, we have this dream to build a Lego city. What is that? For those of you who may not know what that is, Lego, they come up with a lot of realistic stuff. They call them modulars. They're little houses and all that stuff. And you can literally build like an entire city with like cars and planes and buildings of all sorts, housing of all sorts. You can get like a bunch of little houses, put like a row house. I mean, this is really, really cool, right? And so a lot of times a dream or a promise from God can be like that, where God's keeping a lot of stuff in secret, but he's giving you a little box of Legos, like a 300 piece Lego, and he's like, all right, let's put this together. And then that takes you on this journey and this adventure of revelation and insight, and you put it together, and then so you just get a sense that you're coming to a close, and you come to a close, and it's like, and then God moves on and goes where it's something else, and then he gives you another Lego, and it's like, okay, how many Legos, man? Dude, we have done like 78 different Legos already. Wait, my bad. We've done 378 different Legos already. It's like, when do we get to see what you're putting together? You know what I mean? And it's all, and so all you're doing is the Legos. You're not seeing the city being put together and all that. You're not seeing how that's being put together. That's kind of what our life has felt like the past 7 years. You know, God has given us so many prophetic words and dreams and visions and parables and seeing prophetic signs and prophetic numbers that all kind of point to this same idea of this promise and this vision fulfilled, right? And things will change. You know, we've gotten to this point where, you know, because every time you get to the end of the prophetic Lego, you think, oh, this is it, we finished it, this is it. And then God moves on to the next thing, and you go, okay, well, maybe that's not it. Maybe we're not going to get to see the big thing. Well, you can't get to see the big thing until the big thing's ready, right? But I tell you what, man, what God's been doing in our life this past week, that I'm going to save the details for when me and Michelle can be together. But man, it is so much huge preparation, so much. There's one particular vision that I have, real quick, where me and my family, we're in the desert, and Jesus is in the center of this whirlwind, and this whirlwind is being created by these lives of his people that are just revolving around him, and our lives revolve around him so much and so fast, and every breath we take, everything we do is just revolved around him. It creates this kind of tornado, this vortex. And even as we're spinning around, we're constantly looking at him, and he's in the middle, and he's just taking it in like he's feeding off of it. And he's like, yeah. And then he gets to this point where he reaches out his hand, and when he reaches out his hand, things are going so fast. And when he just touches, people are launching out of the whirlwind and into something else, you know? And so the Lord reached out his hand and he touched us, and we launched into this city. You know, it kind of represents of God's miraculous power just launches you into what you're going to do next, you know? And, but in this vision, before we launched, we had this slight little pause, and the Lord spoke something to us, and you could tell, like, we were loaded down in this thing, in this vortex, this tornado. It's like we were like a family that got caught in a snowball, you know, and then we just start rolling down the hill, and we're just stuck in this snowball, a hand coming out here, a foot coming out down there, a head sticking out, and we just stuck in it, because we have been loaded so down with everything that God was preparing for us that we were going to need when he launched us, and then he launched us. So we're just like a ball is flying up. And we feel like, man, that's really been going on this this past week. Loading and unloading. Unloading some stuff. Heart stuff. Mental stuff. Emotional stuff. You know, false ideology stuff. Unrealistic expectation stuff. You know? But then also having grand expectations for what God's going to do. If God said he's going to do it, then expect him to do what he's going to do. That's not unrealistic expectation. That's just expecting God to do what he said he's going to do, right? And in the midst of it, you know, we wake up and it's another day of hearing. It's another day of maybe wondering or questioning, and it's like, and the time can kind of get to you. But the truth of the matter is, there's got to come a point where the Lord says, today is the day, and you go and you see this massive, huge Lego city that you've built by your prayers and your obedience, and God's working on your behalf to do some amazing things. You know, you get to see Legos in the city you forgot you built. You know what I'm saying? You get to see dreams and visions and things come to pass, desires of your heart fulfilled that you forgot you gave up on a long time ago. God's like, I didn't forget, you know? And so I'm just here to encourage somebody that things will change. You can't go on forever. You can't suffer forever. Jesus didn't even stay on the cross forever. It was excruciating, horrible pain. Every second probably felt like an hour's worth of pain. But eventually he came down. Eventually the purpose of God was fulfilled with him being on the cross. You know, eventually what God's doing in your life is going to come to an end point, which will be a new beginning point. That's another thing that the Lord's been speaking to us about. New beginnings. It's got my daughter really excited because God's been very specific about 7 new beginnings that are going to happen in her life, and 7 different healings that are going to happen in her life. Ooh, we're getting deep there. I shouldn't be touching that. That's video worthy stuff. Me and Michelle need to be on that one, but but it's very exciting stuff. And and the problem is, when God starts getting us really excited, soon after that there can come a great big dip and a battle against maybe anxiety and depression, you know, just wondering, when is God gonna do it? It's just like, have you? And then you start dealing with doubt, and it's just like, well, did we even hear right? And all of that stuff. It's like, for me personally, man, I've come too far to be messing around with that stuff. I've come too far to be messing around with anxiety and fear and doubt and depression. All that. No, God's gonna do what he said he's gonna do. And that's just not selling false hope. That's not, it is getting my hopes up, because God wants my hopes to be up, not down. You know what I'm saying? He wants me to be looking forward, because backwards is not the direction we're going. He wants me to be looking up, because that is where my help comes from. Come on now. He wants me to rejoice and be in high spirits. You know? He wants that. He wants that level of faith. He wants that expectancy. He wants that joy. But he knows my heart is kind of hurting sometimes. He knows that. And I straight up tell him sometimes. I'm like, God, going over these dreams and visions and rehearsing the word and the promises, sometimes, man, it's just straight up painful. Because it's like, oh, it just grates at me sometimes. But you know what? I just, over all that grating, over all that bleeding, over all that stuff that's coming out, God, I'm just going to put the confession of your word on it. Like you said, and a lot of times you gotta fight with you gotta use your promise and your word and your vision to battle against the enemy. But sometimes if you're doubting that, just go straight to the word of God. The word of God, it's not something you heard, it's something you've read. And now you've heard it in your spirit, but you can go directly to the written word and says, this is what your word says. You will never leave me or forsake me. You will never leave me without support. You will not, you know what I'm saying? Whatever it is that you need, you are the healer. You are the deliverer. You are, you see what I'm saying? You just got to get the written word on it. Get the written word on it, you know, and then that will actually give you that'll actually kind of pump you up to give you the courage and maybe align your spirit to be able to confess what God has spoken to you directly with confidence, to be able to pray for it with confidence, you know? So don't worry, things will change. Things never stay the same. If you've been alive longer than 10 years, you know things never stay the same. They always change. And when God is in control, when God is in control, they always change for the better. I know sometimes we get thrown into a pit. I know sometimes it seems like we're getting elevated, and we are, but then there's a Potiphar wife situation, and it's like, and you didn't even do anything wrong, and you're still getting in trouble for it. But it's all, every step of the righteous is ordered by the Lord. Every step of the righteous is ordered by the Lord. He trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not on your own understanding. Acknowledge him in all of your ways, and he will direct your path, make your path straight. You know what I'm saying? So just know that you do not labor in vain. I think that's a, what is that, 1 Corinthians 15:58. You do not labor in vain. You do not. You know, it's there's nothing is wasted. Jesus said, pick up all the leftovers, and so that nothing is wasted. What they have, they had 12 baskets full of leftovers from a boy's lunch. And those were the leftovers. They had 1,000 times more leftovers than what they started with. You know what I'm saying? That's how God works when he's in the miraculous business of your life, you know? That all that stuff that happened to Joseph, that was a pathway to the palace. It didn't look good, you know, so your life may not look good. It may not look right. You may be suffering. You may be hurting. You may be suffering in body, suffering in heart, suffering in spirit, suffering in your emotions, suffering in your mind. You might be suffering financially. You might be suffering relationally. You might be suffering in your family. You might be suffering in every way imaginable. You know, you might be suffering in your ministry. You might be suffering in your career. You might be suffering. But if God is with you and you are walking humbly with God and you just, God, I may not understand. I may not know everything that's going on. But what I do know is you. And I know that your word is true. You are faithful and true. And this will not end in misery and shame and disappointment. You know the thoughts and plans that you have for us, thoughts for welfare, peace, and hope in our final outcome. Amen. So come on, people. Come on, you gotta go. You better get into the gym. Get into the gym and start lifting your faith weights. Start lifting your faith, you know? You know, you go to the gym, you lift weights. We go to the kingdom of God, we lift up faith. Faith in the word of God, okay? And so don't get caught up in the bugaboos of the enemy. You know what I'm saying? Don't get caught up. He's a liar. He's been a liar from the beginning. He is not telling you the truth. He wants you to be afraid. He wants you to be anxious and depressed and fearful and believe that God's lying to you, or the promise or the vision is not as cool as you might think it is. And he wants you to be disappointed. He wants you to be discouraged. He wants you to be all of those things. Because he doesn't want you to inherit the promise. He wants you to lose faith. So don't lose faith. This is why the scripture says in Revelation a couple times, hold fast to what you have. Hold on to what you have so that your crown will not be stolen. Because the enemy will convince you to just lay it down and give it up. Don't give in to that mess. Don't give in to that mess. God spoke to you. Have confidence. You didn't hear wrong. And even if you did hear wrong, I know you didn't hear everything wrong. You might have heard some stuff, not maybe didn't get this right, or maybe you put that bolt in here when it was supposed to go here. Okay, that's fine. That's not speaking to the whole message. And what does it say in Philippians 3:15? It says, and if we're wrong in anything, God will correct us and make it right. You know, just seek him. You know? So don't be discouraged. Be encouraged that this things will change. Things will change. Say it. Things will change. God is on my side. Things will change. I'm going higher, not lower. And I'm not even going to stay on the same plane. I'm going higher. I'm going up. Okay? So pray that bless you guys. I will see you next video. Bye-bye.